By 1940, country musicians had had access to the radio airwaves for 15 years. But Southern black blues musicians had not been so fortunate. All that changed in 1941 in the old Mississippi River port town of Helena, Arkansas, 50 miles south of Memphis. There on station KFFA, the next chapter of the blues was being written by Sonny Boy Williamson.
We were the first radio station ever to put an Afro-American group on the air here in the Delta. We were the first.
It all started when Sonny Boy Williamson and Robert Jr. Lockwood, who was taught guitar by his stepfather, Robert Johnson, wanted Sonny Payne to help them get on the radio to advertise their gigs in juke joints around Helena. What resulted was one of the longest-running daily radio shows in America, still hosted today by Sonny Payne.
Sonny Boy and Robert Jr. came up and says, "Is the manager in? He's in his office. I think he's going to lunch. What's up?" They said, "We want to try and see if we can get on the air." Sam sent him over to Max Moore of Interstate Grocery Company and told him they'd have to have a sponsor. Max Moore said, "I'll tell you what I'll do. I got a boxcar load of King Biscuit flour. It's been on the market since 1930, and I can't give it away."
KFFA and the local grocer agreed to sponsor Sonny Boy and Robert Jr.'s show. They called it the King Biscuit Time.
When we started broadcasting, I think we was about the first. We opened doors for a lot of other people.
2 days after they started, the King Biscuit Time show was something. People, they had never heard anything like it. Before it was over, Max had ordered another boxcar load of King Biscuit flour.
I mean, everywhere we played, that place would fill up for $2.50 and $3 a head, up to $5 a head. Sonny Boy was one of the greatest. I don't care how many of them come and go, he was one of the greatest.
Bye, bye, bird. Bye, bye. Suddenly, all kinds of people, both black and white, were hearing the blues at lunchtime, including James Cotton, a 9-year-old who was earning a lot more money playing harmonica than picking cotton.
"There'll never be another harmonica player in the world like him."
He came over here, I think, when he was about 9 or 10 and watched Sonny Boy. Then as he grew older, say 11 or 12, Sonny Boy took him under his wing.
"Blood, I'm gone. Find myself."
Watched everything that he did. I watched every move he made, every word he said. I want to be just like Sonny Boy. And he wanted to sound big. He'd be playing. "Every morning for breakfast, King Biscuit on my table. Every morning for breakfast, King Biscuit on my table. I invite my friends, all my next door neighbors. Every morning for breakfast, Robert Jr. away from 9 to 10. Every morning for breakfast, Robert Jr. away from 9 to 10. Every time I look around, she ain't cut the street on the plate again."
Sonny Boy could make that thing sound like a 20-piece band. Because when you got Robert Jr. Lockwood backing you up, you'd think you're listening to a 15-piece outfit back there.
"Come on, baby.
walk with me. To the same old place where we long to be.
Come on. Being on a plantation, you had an hour off at noon. So I would come out of the fields at noon. Sonny Boy Williamson would come on about 12:15. So we had a chance to listen to 15 minutes of live music from one of the guys that I liked a lot, Sonny Boy Williamson. And KFFA was the only station in the area at that time that played music by black people.
B.B. King used to listen to this radio show. And then in 1948, I never will forget, he came through here and he stopped off and talked to Sonny Boy a little while.
B.B. King suspected that he could make more money playing guitar than driving a tractor on a plantation. Like lots of other musicians, he headed up Highway 61 to Memphis and began to play on street corners and clubs around Beale Street, which was becoming a center for the blues.
When B.B. came to Memphis, he was wearing a shoe and a boot, and everybody called him Shoe Booty.
When I first left Mississippi, going to Memphis and Beale Street was like today leaving here, going to Berlin, France, you know, Paris or London or someplace. I'd never been there, and it's only 130 miles north of where I was born. But God, to go there, this great big city, there was famous people that would come in Memphis and they hang on Beale Street. But it was a whole way of learning that was new for B.B. King.
Just a few years after the King Biscuit Time began broadcasting the blues, WDIA, a white-owned station in Memphis, decided to try an all-black blues and gospel format with both Rufus Thomas and B.B. King as disc jockeys. It revolutionized music in America.
WDIA was the first all-black station in the nation. They were looked upon. Now listen to this now. And they put all-black music on that. Had taken off the quote-unquote good pop music and put on this trash.
We don't want to hear that in me.
I got a sweet little angel.
Telling you what I know, I was there.
I love
you know, 2 weeks later, we the number one station in the city. And white college kids used to come on my radio show at midnight. They could have gone to a white station. They didn't want that. That's not what they wanted. They want to come where they wanted to hear the music that they liked.
Sam Phillips opened a recording studio to record the blues artists that were gaining popularity in Memphis.
I just had that deep, burning desire about black people and white people that had no opportunity whatsoever to display their potential talents. And honey, let me tell you something. People ask me, how did you get the word around? Oh, you didn't need anybody with a bullhorn saying, there's a recording studio here. Chester Burnett, the Howlin' Wolf, as of course he's known, was probably one of the most loved entertainers because there was something about the wolf that young people liked.
Tell yourself, darling, I'll be back someday. You know, good friend.
I guess there's some people that have that ability to communicate, regardless of what kind of voice, maybe regardless of the moves they have. The wolf had it, shall I say, in abundance.
Yeah.